The Rock has acknowledged the tribal chief Roman Reigns, and an AEW champion has lost a title versus career match. But first, Bray Wyatt's WWE return included some tributes to Brodie Lee. This past Saturday night, the White Rabbit mystery would lead to the reveal of Bray Wyatt, who made his return to WWE at the end of the Extreme Rules pay-per-view. With that said, it looks like Wyatt and WWE added a few Easter eggs and nods to the late Brodie Lee, who was part of the Wyatt family during his run in WWE as Luke Harper. The first tribute came during the reveal of the Firefly Funhouse puppets in human form, who were scattered around the crowd leading up to the reveal. One of the characters that was seen was Abby the Witch, who was wearing the familiar black head veil and dress. On top of this, though, she was wearing a mask that eagle-eyed fans noticed was the mask of Luke Harper during his run in the Bludgeon Brothers alongside Eric Rowan. And then, before Bray would make his way through the door positioned at the top of the entrance ramp, a blue light would shine through that was also a familiar sight to fans of All Elite Wrestling. If you look back at the debut of Brodie Lee in AEW, when he was revealed as the Exalted One, he would make his way through a corridor on the vignette that played before his appearance, and the exact same blue lighting could be seen. Bray and Brodie were of course very close friends before the latter's passing in December 2020, with these subtle tributes a great touch from both Wyatt and WWE. This isn't the first time that Wyatt has paid tribute to Lee through his WWE characters, however, as during the last match of his previous run, his jacket would feature the same Bludgeon Brothers mask, as well as the flannel pattern Harper would wear, although unfortunately it was never seen outside of the transformation video right before his entrance. He would also use Brodie's yeah, yeah, yeah catchphrase, with more tributes likely to be sprinkled in his work going forward. And speaking of Bray Wyatt, his brother Bo Dallas could be set for a WWE return. As mentioned, Bray Wyatt would not be alone during his WWE return, with him joined by real-life forms of his Firefly Funhouse puppets, with many feeling this is the Wyatt Six that his current Twitter name is hinting towards. We may now know the identity of one of the individuals under the masks, as it seems Wyatt's real-life brother Bo Dallas is set to follow him back to WWE. According to Brian Alvarez of Wrestling Observer, he would be back very soon, with him taking to Twitter to say, "From multiple sources, Bo Dallas should be back very soon." For what it's worth, before Extreme Rules, Fightful Select would report that whilst there will be one of the reveals at Extreme Rules, it wasn't the reveal, with many expecting this to be the reveal of the Wyatt Six. If he does indeed become a member of the Wyatt Six, this will be the first time the two have been aligned on screen since their days in WWE's developmental system FCW, where they were in fact tag team champions at one point. They would then once again become single stars, going their separate ways, only ever working as opponents since then. Dallas has been a free agent since April 2021, 3 months before Wyatt was let go from the company, and the former NXT champion has hinted at working with his brother once again in the future, and it looks like we may be getting closer to seeing it happen, something fans feel is long overdue. Whilst Vince McMahon didn't see much in Bo Dallas upon his call to the main roster, let's not forget that new head of creative Triple H made him the third ever NXT champion back in 2013, which was part of his excellent heel run at the time. On top of this, Bo is only 32 years old despite his long career, and still has a ton of potential if used correctly, as shown during his time in developmental. And next up, SARAYA has discussed her return to in-ring competition. Following her AEW debut at Dynamite Grand Slam on August 21st, fans have speculated if SARAYA will be able to wrestle again following her retirement from wrestling in 2018 due to neck problems. The answer to the question was seemingly revealed last week when she would get physical in the ring after being confronted by Britt Baker, where she would throw punches before delivering a superkick to Rebel, this after the six-woman tag match on Dynamite. She would then tell the crowd that this is her house. SARAYA has now addressed the situation during one of her Twitch streams this week, revealing that during her time in WWE after the injury, the discussion of returning to the ring didn't come up, and she would say, "We never had that discussion. I never had that discussion with WWE because they let me go. I've been working years to better myself and be healthier and stronger. Me mentally, I never brought it up because I had this mental block. I want to be as safe as possible. I know what my body can do. Me and WWE never had that discussion about having a match. I never brought it up to them about me potentially wrestling. If I was to talk to them about it, I'm sure they would do the research. I wasn't mentally ready." She would then go on to say that she knows her limitations and that she can't start bumping like crazy, with her adding, "It still makes me nervous, but I'm way smarter about it. I know what I can and can't do. I'm not expecting to do 6 German suplexes off the top. I'm not that wrestler anyway. I'm not looking to bump around like crazy like I did before. I need to make adjustments and be smart about it. I'm very aware of what I can and can't do." Saraya would confirm that she agreed terms with AEW 2 weeks before Grand Slam, this after WWE let her contract expire in July of this year. It seems that her return to the ring will see her take on Britt Baker as their feud continues to develop on AEW television, with the match likely set for the next pay-per-view, Full Gear, on November 19th from the Prudential Center in Newark, New Jersey. Next up, the main event of Wrestle Kingdom 17 has been confirmed. In January 2023, New Japan Pro Wrestling will hold their biggest show of the year live from the Tokyo Dome. Earlier today, New Japan would confirm the main event for the show, with their former IWGP World Heavyweight Champion set to take on the reigning champion. At the New Japan Declaration of Power event, Bullet Club's Jay White would successfully defend his world title against former stablemate Tama Tonga before going on to cut a post-match promo. He would then be interrupted by this year's G1 Climax winner Kazushika Okada, who himself scored a victory earlier on in the night against Jonah. The two men would then face off before the announcement was made that they will now headline the Tokyo Dome on January 4th, with this being the 7th time Okada has main evented the Tokyo Dome show, not including separate nights of one-year events, with it being Jay's second ever Wrestle Kingdom main event. Right now, White is 4-1 in singles matches over Okada, with him winning their last Wrestle Kingdom match in 2019. So far, this is the only match to be confirmed participant-wise, whilst it has been announced that the first ever NJPW World Television Champion will be crowned at the show, although the competitors aren't yet known, with the first ever IWGP Women's Championship match, with a tournament currently taking place to find the finalists. On top of this, the promotion have announced that the show will be held in tribute to the founder of New Japan, Antonio Inoki, who sadly passed away on October 1st. But who leaves Tokyo as IWGP World Heavyweight Champion this January? Let me know in the comments down below. And next, The Rock has acknowledged the Tribal Chief. One of the hottest, if not the hottest act in WWE right now is the Bloodline, led by the head of the table, Roman Reigns. With WrestleMania 39 in Hollywood just around the corner, fans are anticipating the return of The Rock to stake claim to the top of the family tree, with the company hopeful that this can happen. While appearing in a new interview with Chris Van Vliet to promote his new movie, Black Adam, The Rock would discuss Roman's work in WWE right now, admitting that he acknowledges him, and he would say, "Of course I do, that's my family. I think those guys are doing a great job, and I think what an interesting shift that the company has gone through this year, unexpected in many ways. But when unexpectations happen in that kind of way, form and fashion, especially in that business, you've got to have the ability and the agility to pivot, which they have. So with Roman, I think he's doing a pretty good job, and the boys too, the Usos as well." The biggest shift in WWE this year, of course, has been the retirement of Vince McMahon, with Triple H taking over the creative duties of the main roster shows. The new head of creative has admitted that he is keen on bringing the Great One back at some point for a match with Roman, reminding him that the clock is always ticking. But do you think The Rock will be back for next year's Hollywood WrestleMania? Let me know in the comments down below. And next, an AEW champion has lost a title versus career match. Last week, news broke that AEW World Champion Jon Moxley had signed a brand new contract with the company, extending his stay till 2027. In the press statement provided by All Elite Wrestling, it noted that he would now exclusively appear for AEW and their international partners, such as New Japan Pro Wrestling. This left the future of Moxley on the indies up in the air, with him appearing in GCW, Revolver, Defy, and Northeast Wrestling over the course of 2022 thus far. Well, it looks like we now have confirmation of Moxley's GCW departure, as this past weekend he would put his GCW World Championship on the line against Nick Gage in a title versus career match, and if Moxley lost, he would be forced to leave the company for good. In the end, Gage would leave as champion in one of the biggest wins of his career, with Moxley now officially done with Game Changer Wrestling. After the match, a report would then emerge from Fightful Select, who had some additional notes on the situation. GCW few sources state that AEW didn't actually want Moxley to do the match and have been asking talents not to do GCW dates for months, but with that said, he insisted on finishing his run there as champion. During the match, two members of the firm, Stokely Hathaway and W. Morrissey, who have been assisting MJF in AEW as of late, would get involved in the match to help cost Moxley his title, with Fightful noting that GCW had no say in the ending of the match or how it played out, with this seemingly coming down to AEW and Tony Khan, perhaps as a make-good for allowing the match to happen and to keep their world champion strong in the process. Those Fightful spoke to believe that Mox will still have the ability to work independent dates, but believe it will be on a surprise basis if it ends up happening at all. This is in contrast to in the past, where promotions would throw everything at the promotion of one of the shows that Moxley would appear on. But what do you make of John Moxley's now limited schedule on the independent circuit, and does it make sense? Let me know what you think in the comments down below. And before you go, make sure you check out every All In wrestler that didn't sign for AEW.